house tonight, boys. Time to start the show. You feel me? Let's give these fans what they paid for and won. You feel me? Let's do it.
It's a Western Conference battle at the FedEx Forum in downtown Memphis as the Grizzlies look to work the home court advantage. And now a quick check of our starting lineups for both teams. One of the guys we'll be watching out for today, Jerick. Landsberg is guarded by Davis. Here's the Beast, arms length from the hoop, he knocks it down.
Well, they've settled into their offense very quickly here today.
Yeah, they're zoned in, making the most out of their possessions here.
Paul outside. Davis kicks to Paul. Six on the shot clock. Paul left side. Drops one in from the wing. We've got 108 left in the first quarter of the game. Pass to Landisberg. Pass to Gotti. There's the three. Here's the Beast. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
And the defense looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Yeah, I like that. A foul to save the layup. Make him earn it at the line.
And the Warriors making a change here.
They're really earning their living at the line today.
You talk about earning a living at the line, there's been a big disparity between these teams.
Well, I think, Kevin, you get fouls by getting into the lane and driving to the hoop. One team is more aggressive, the other team's a little more passive, and that's why you have the disparity.
Good luck. It has taken them no time to build this lead up on the strength of a great first quarter offensively.
And they need to continue to put pressure on the defense and try to really run away with this one from here.
They get it back. Pass coming up. Paul feeds it to Thompson. Outside, Davis. Paul gets a screen from Huminga. Paul passes to Thompson. The putback throws it down with the quick putback jam.
Tell you what, coaches love to see that kind of hustle, guys. I mean, getting after it on the offensive board, that's always a winning play.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, coaches love to see the hustle, but the fans love to see the dunk.
Oh, we've seen...
Feel the excitement of NBA basketball. Come out and root for your Grizzlies. The Beast, a terrific starring attraction, not to be missed. So get your tickets now. Come out and welcome our sensational new rookie.
And out of bounds as Memphis gains possession. And Doris Burke has a report for us from the sideline.
Thanks, Kevin. The Beast in their last matchup against the Nuggets provided a nice lift. He chipped in his share of points, but also put up four boards. It was a great contribution from someone who is considered a bit more of a role player on his team.
Thank you, Doris. He was the player they leaned on that night, Steve, and he didn't disappoint them.
No, he didn't. In fact, he did everything they asked of him and more. And I think he really enjoys being that go-to guy for them.
Yeah, I think he relishes that because he knows he's capable of doing it. He's had some performances that have fortified his confidence in that role. So he's in a good place right now.
Setting the floor for the Warriors. We've got Draymond Green. Gary Payton is out there with Steph Curry. And it's Wiggins in at the small forward position.
Boy, that was solid. I tell you, he's one of the best there is up there at the foul line.
Kicks to Williams. Pulls up. And it's good off the back of the rim and in. And the Grizzlies lead by seven. Payton outside. He passes Kuminga. Rebounded by Jackson. Jackson's got his third rebound tonight. Here's Knarr. Offline with his three.
And if they know what's good for him, that's the way they'll defend against him every time he takes the ball into three-point territory.
Well, you're right. Anything less than airtight defense on him will usually result in 3 points.
He kicks to Green.
No good.
Williams with the defensive effort. Well, for Memphis, their last game a loss to the Nuggets.
Their offense really sputtered in that game. They went through stretches where points became very hard to come by.
And Steve, you know, their play wasn't terrible. It wasn't too bad, but this game still is about making shots, and the shot making wasn't there.
And blocked, tipped away. And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played, here's Morant. Makes good on the step-back jumper. He's got eight.
You know, his ability is matched only by his energy, guys. I mean, he's usually in the middle of everything for his team.
Green kicks to Curry. And the three ball is good.
You know, offensively, he's just one of those guys that needs a touch of space to get his shot up. That's all. And if he runs his man off a screen or somehow finds an opening, that's it. He's going to let that thing go.
And his attitude, Steve, just his general poise and presence is something else you notice about him. He's really a calming influence over that team.
And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
Thanks for joining
the Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
So it's the Grizzlies now. They lead by one. This game against Golden State is the first time they've met this season.
And, of course, they're meeting the team that was responsible for dealing them a very painful loss in the first round of the playoffs a year ago.
And for Golden State, we've got Steph Curry, and it's Green in at the center position. The Warriors have been good at the free throw line. This one is 7 of 8. Steve just talked about their postseason last year, and Clark, I'll bet they're still thinking about how quickly this team bounced them out of the playoffs.
Yeah, you got to believe that, Kevin. I mean, their first chance this season for a little bit of revenge, they're salivating.
From deep, Williams. The Warriors pull it in. Green's got his fourth rebound in this one. They defeated the Pelicans in their last game.
And I think, Kevin, you know, it really showed how important it is to have a strong bench performance. If you go out on the road, you can't rely on your starters night in and night out. The reserves have to contribute and help them out.
I think we definitely saw that, Steve, throughout the game. They were really tied together as a team. Didn't make any difference who was out on the floor. You'll take every road game win you can, and they're happy with that one.
Some nice passing there by Memphis. Three-pointer. Five on the clock. And another miss by Memphis.
He's going to play his way right onto the bench and out of the game if he continues to shoot it like he has so far in this quarter.
The Warriors have gone 9 of 10 from the line, so making the most of their chances.
Well, to this point of the season, guys, they're knocking down about 76%.
Dish to Clark. The pass to the Beast. Defended by Kuminga. Here's the Beast. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up. Here's what Memphis has lined up on their schedule. They'll face the Lakers after this one. That'll be at home. That will complete this four-game homestand. And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach so far that we've seen for the Warriors?
So far, they've turned in a fantastic performance from the three-point line. It's been a weapon all game.
And I love their hustle because they're getting a lot of second chance opportunities just as a result of playing hard.
And for Golden State, Klay Thompson is out there with Chris Paul. Then there's Draymond Green, and it's rolling out at the center. Shoots the three, and good on the basket. Book it.
You might not think of him as a laser three-point shooter, but that shot was there for him, and he had to take it.
Back to Paul. He feeds it to Thompson from past the arc. It's rebounded by Memphis.
He just has not been able to get into that groove yet, guys. But as a whole, it hasn't affected them too much.
Payne. And again, it's the Grizzlies from deep.
This is unbelievable. What a shooting exhibition we're seeing out there today.
The Warriors trail. Paul outside. Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. Kuminga, the pass to Thompson. Kuminga, clock at six. Backs him down. Golden State needs to get off a shot. Paul with the three, gets the bucket. And the Warriors lead by two.
Right back at you. They immediately get those 3 points back.
Trading punches, that's how you answer.
Plastic running. Here's Morant. And again, it's Memphis with the three.
That's three in a row, guys. 3 three-pointers consecutively. These guys are just raining in shots.
Yeah, the defenders can't be as soft as they've been on the perimeter there.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Kevin, during that last break, I heard the Warriors coach as he addressed his team. He told them, this is it, fellas. Let's hit them right out of this timeout. Put some pressure on them. Show them how much you want it. Let's go get it. Guys, he's really exhorting them to give them a burst of energy.
There's the pick. Passes to the Beast. Working on Green. Here's the Beast. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Green's got 6 rebounds here tonight. And Thompson gets it to go in on the assist by Green. And now a 3-point Warrior lead. And for Memphis, they're shooting straight 49% from the field. The Beast defended by Kuminga. Here's the Beast. And he'll have a chance for a 3-point play. Kuminga. And so he's picked up his final foul. And he will sit for the rest of this game. And the Warriors making a change here. That's good from the Beast.
Great job getting to the bucket and getting to the free throw line. You know, when the game's close, you want your guys attacking just like that.
Now here's Curry. D right on him. Looney.
Oh, what a basket, and at the perfect time.
How about the courage and backbone of this guy? Wow.
Plastic body. Here's Morant. Nails the three.
He is bombing it today. How many more threes are we going to see from him?
Well, we've already seen plenty. The majority of his points have come on that shot.
Here's Curry. Buries it.
Whoa, that's a big shot right there.
And that one really took the air out of this crowd.
Kevin, the silence is deafening.
Here's Roddy trying his luck deep. And it's Curry with the rebound. And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet.
Yet.
Tough loss tonight. You might even say the team took a collective punch to the stomach giving that one up. What are you thinking after losing a game that many people would say you should have won?
I'm thinking we missed a great chance, that's for sure. We probably didn't deserve to win that game, but to be close enough at the end to pull it out meant that we missed a golden opportunity. Those are the kind of games you can't let get away if you want to make the playoffs. After a while, those losses add up. And we don't want to be on the outside looking in come postseason wondering what might have been. You feel me?